The state of matrimony is understood by us as a state ennobled and enriched by a long and honorable tradition of devotion, set on the basis of the law of the land, assuring each participant equality before the law, and supporting the common rights of each party to the marriage. There's assumed to be desire for a lifelong companionship and a generous sharing of the help and comfort that a couple ought to have from each other through whatever circumstances of sickness, or health, joy or sorrow, prosperity or adversity the lives these parties may experience. Marriage is therefore not to be entered upon thoughtlessly or irresponsibly, with a due and serious understanding and appreciation of the ends for which it is undertaken, and of the material, intellectual, and emotional factors which will govern its performance. It's by its nature a state of giving rather than of taking, of offering rather than receiving. For marriage requires the giving of oneself to support the marriage and the home in which it may flourish. Yet to this high and serious state, these two fine people desire to unite. Therefore, I charge and require of you both, in the presence of all your witnesses, that if either of you know any legal impediment to this marriage, you would not reveal the same. So, Craig, I'm going to ask you please to repeat after me. I solemnly declare that I do not know, that I do not know,
I do not know
of any lawful impediment.
Any lawful impediment.
Why I, Craig, may not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Sherine. I solemnly declare.
I solemnly declare
that I do not know.
That I do not know
of any lawful impediment.
That I do not know any lawful impediment.
Why I, Sherine.
Why I, Sherine,
may not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Craig.
To Craig.
There's been no reason given why I should not marry this couple today. So now I'm going to ask them questions. Craig. Do you undertake to afford to Sherine the love of your person, the comfort of your companionship, and the patience of your understanding, and to share equally of the necessities of life, as they may be earned or enjoyed by you, to respect the dignity of her person, her own personal rights, and to recognize the right of counsel and consultation upon all matters relating to the present or the future, the household established by this marriage, or to pray the love of your person, the comfort of your companionship, and the patience of your understanding, and to share equally of the necessities of life, as they may be earned or enjoyed by you, to respect the dignity of his person, his own personal rights, and to recognize the right of counsel and consultation upon all matters relating to the present or the future of the household established by this marriage.
I need one.
I don't think anybody's
going to. No, of course, none of us brought it.
Sherine. I call on those present.
I call on those present.
To witness that I, Sherine.
To witness that I, Sherine.
Take you, Craig.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband. To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In whatever circumstance.
In whatever circumstance.
Or experience.
Or experience.
Your mom has them.
Your mom has them.
Mom has the rings.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Inasmuch as you have made this declaration, your vows concerning one another, and have set these rings before me, I ask now that these rings be used and regarded as a seal of confirmation and acceptance of the vows that you have made. Craig, please take the rings and put them on Sherine's finger. Please repeat that. With these rings, as the token and pledge,
as the token and pledge
of the vow and covenant of my word,
of the vow and covenant of my word,
I call upon those persons present.
I call upon those persons present
to witness that I, Craig,
to witness I, Craig,
take you, Sherine,
take you, Sherine,
to be my lawful wedded wife,
to be my lawful wedded wife.
Receiving this ring.
In receiving this ring.
Being the token and pledge.
Being the token and pledge.
The covenant of your word.
The covenant of your word.
I call upon those persons present.
I call upon those persons present.
To witness that I, Sherine.
To witness that I, Sherine.
Take you, Craig.
Take you, Craig.
Be my lawful wedded husband.
Be my lawful wedded husband.
Please put this ring on Craig's finger. With this ring,
with this ring,
I promise and give to you,
I promise and give to you,
the truth and faithfulness,
the truth and faithfulness
of my life and marriage,
of my life and marriage.
In receiving this ring,
in receiving this ring,
I promise and give to you,
I promise and give to you,
the truth and faithfulness,
the truth and faithfulness
of my life and marriage. May you both enjoy length of days, fulfillment of hopes, and peace, and contentment of mind.
What's this?
Day by day live to fulfill the terms of this covenant that you have just made with one another. And now for as much as you, Craig, and you, Sherine, have consented in legal wedlock, and have declared your solemn intention in this company before all your witnesses and in my presence, and have exchanged these rings as the pledge of your vows to each other. Now, upon the authority vested in me by the province of British Columbia, it gives me a great deal of pleasure to pronounce that you are husband and wife.
Now, what I'd like to do is it's a canoe song for your new journey.
And this is it gives me so much pleasure to sing this song for you. Yo ho ho way, yo ho ho way, yo ho ho way, yo ho ho way. Woo!